trying to find to make the full picture. So, dear Professor Pfeiffer, my co-chair, ladies and gentlemen, good evening. First, let me thank Professor Evanthia Diamanti-Kantarakis for the invitation. Then, let me thank Professor Evanthia Diamanti-Kantarakis and also Eleni Kantarakis for their persistence and their perseverance in organizing this course against so many difficulties. We have not only Xenophon, Zorbas, and some other personalities who are taking over the country. But what happened here in Mati about 2 months ago, 99 deaths, many more who have not been identified yet, is the biggest human catastrophe in the history of Attica and, in fact, of Europe. But, you know, life should go on. And whatever it happens between today and then, tomorrow is another day. This is the most emotional photo of the whole catastrophe here. This lady with her child on the shore. Now we proceed, and I'd like here to talk with you about the psychotropic drugs and thyroid dysfunctions. The outline, we're going to talk about psychoactive drugs and thyroid dysfunctions, some notes of etiopathogenesis, and the case which will be discussed later on. Psychoactive or psychotropics are chemicals that, by modifying brain function, induce alterations of perception, mood, consciousness, cognition, or behavior. Their use is dating back at least 10,000 years prehistory, mostly as plants, as, for example, the chewing of coca leaves in Peru. They are classified as anxiolytics, for example, benzodiazepines and barbiturates, empathogen, ecstasy, or LSD, stimulants, amphetamine, caffeine, cocaine, depressants, hypnotics and barbiturates, and hallucinogens, psychedelics, delirians. They have, many of them, a high degree of addiction. And indeed, you may see here that the addiction, the degree and inducing of harm is variable, for example, among ecstasy. And some other benzodiazepine, barbiturates, cocaine, and heroin on the top. The exact mechanism of addiction is not well known. But 10 days ago, it has been published this paper in Proceedings of National Academy of Sciences. And I think it was very interesting. I was really very much interested in that because it looks like that an ancient retrovirus infection that has occurred 1,000 years ago and has been incorporated into the human body before even the appearance of Neanderthal and hold this translation factor, this gene RAS GRF2, regulates dopaminergic action in the brain. by interfering with dopamine and thus with the brain reward center. You know, the dopamine is very important to for the reward. It is also, it has a crucial role in the addiction process. So it increases the likelihood that a person will seek behaviors that increase enjoyment and consequently addiction to drugs. So it looks like that we're coming closer to the clarification of the addiction process. Psychotropic medications are prescribed as antidepressants to treat clinical depression or antipsychotics for the management of psychotic syndromes such as schizophrenia, severe mania, as mood stabilizers and anxiolytics in treating anxiety disorders. Many drugs can interfere with thyroid hormone function by suppressing the TSH axis, or by interfering with LT4 absorption. It depending also of of other comorbidities of the patient. And here in the department C, you see that lithium, which is the most prescribed drug in depression, and also tricyclic and sertraline and the epileptics, well, SSRIs and phenothiazine may induce primary hypothyroidism, means it's affecting directly thyroid gland. Indeed, here, in a rather recent study by Bunevicius, you see that patients who were treated with antipsychotic drugs, 73% did not had any effect, any change in thyroid hormones, or showed a slight decrease. And 27% showed an increase in FT3, 34% increase in FT4, and almost 60% increase in TSH. So, well, these drugs are commonly interfere with thyroid function and may disrupt thyroid gland. The mechanisms are not well known. There are regularly or mainly two main mechanisms that that have been taken into consideration: an increased hepatic degradation of thyroid hormones, which could be possibly an explanation for the goitrogenic effect as a compensatory mechanism, and altered protein binding or interference of hypothalamic pituitary thyroid axis. Well, we have a possible effect in all the departments, or centrally, thyroid hypothalamic pituitary, or in the liver, with the binding of thyroid hormones to binding proteins, or affecting the degradation of thyroid hormones, or the conversion of T4 to T3. Several mechanisms. We all know that hypothyroidism has a variety of symptoms, and that many of these symptoms are likely also in patients with depression. And indeed, here with Professor Mailis, we had made an analysis, and fatigue, depressed mood, weight gain, sleepiness, decreased appetite, hair loss, and low libido, it looks like to be in between hypothyroidism and depression. But you see, of course, that there are many more here symptoms between these both states. And there is also an escalation of hypothyroid symptomatic in depression. And it looks like that these neuropsychiatric features are dependent on the degree of hypothyroidism. And indeed, as the TSH is rising, the variability and also the severity of the symptoms are rising. There is an overlap of subjects with both diseases, depression and raised TSH. And the biggest study investigating this issue was the HAND 2, including more than 30,000 patients. And they have found that 1.2% of those patients with depression, according to the hospital analyzing depression disorders, 11.7%, overt hypothyroidism was about 1.2%. Please take in note that from this 1.2%, about 0.3%, well, almost one third, had a neuroleptic malignant syndrome or a serotonin syndrome. The most common drug for treating depression is lithium, universally speaking. So lithium has an effect, a disruptive effect on thyroid by increasing thyroid volume. And indeed, here, from a current book that we have, has been published recently by Vitti and Hegedus, this picture is taken from Perilt from the 80s. And you can see that, especially in women, goiter was found much more with a much higher frequency as compared to men regarding lithium treatment, also the time of treatment. And the goiter was induced only in within 1 month. And after we had a regression of thyroid volume following withdrawal of lithium salts. The mechanisms here are not very well defined, but a paper by Rao showed that lithium may suppress a translational factor, GSK 3 beta, which is very important in inducing WNT catechin. And by repressing the gene, and also by induce suppression of the phosphorylation, and depending on the dose, you see here that by 10 micromillits, we could have an effect. So it lithium may have an effect on thyroid depending on the dose. And this effect is hyperplastic, by not only by affecting the TSH cyclic adenosine AMP reaction, but also via the WNT catechin pathway. And again, here from Dayan, the association of depression with TSH in males and females from the HAND study. And you see that as the TSH increases, we have a more higher frequency of depression. But also in low TSH level, for example, here, especially in females, we have a depression, a higher depression frequency, and it looks like the men had a higher frequency than in women with low TSH. Well, there is a variability, there is a gender effect. Anti-epileptic drugs, I apologize, and thyroid function. Most of these drugs, or the anti-epileptics, may have a hypothyroid effect on raising the TSH, decreasing the thyroid hormones, and also decreasing the TBG protein. And there are among them various, the degree, the severity of the disruption is dependent on the dose, on the length of treatment, and also of the basal status of the patients. And it is interesting that the phenytoin not only has the higher effect, the most potent effect, but also timely speaking, it may induce a hypothyroid within 12 months and even earlier than the others, that they have a lower degree of hypothyroid induction. Well, phenytoin, it looks like to be the most potent anti-epileptic drug in disrupting thyroid function. Which are the covariates for a cumulative incidence for hypothyroidism? Well, treatment, we have seen that, for example, using lithium as a reference, dummy variables are created for non-lithium treatment. Age at treatment, the higher reverse and adverse effects among older patients. The sex, it looks like a higher frequency of hypothyroidism among female patients, and also whether thyroid function testing was performed 14 days preceding monotherapy. It can be also of importance to detect any thyroid pathology before starting treatment. And pre-treatment prescriptions and comorbidities. There are many other factors and drugs and metabolic issues that may play a role in these disrupting effects. And here, this interesting, busy but interesting slide showing the incidence of hypothyroidism at the baseline. This is the A. And then when the monotherapy was ending, and subtracting here by some complicated statistical methods, the basal levels, you see that lithium again, then other drugs like amphiprazole may have a high incidence of hypothyroidism. And also depending on the time of exposure. And here, in another diagrammatically presented manner, the hypothyroidism frequency among bipolar therapies, and you see lithium, and for example, is the first inducing hypothyroidism as compared to all the others. And please take care that carbamazepine, which was supposed to be very toxic for thyroid, it was not found. This study taken about 15,000 patients. There are many data, there are many papers, but I prefer to show you these papers with a higher content of patients. Another group is this selective serotonin receptor inhibitors. Because, you know, serotonin and thyroid and SSRIs have a very tight connection. For example, thyrotropin-releasing hormone is constantly inhibited by serotonin. And we know that serotonin plays an important role in mood and also in the pathology of depression. On the other hand, reduced intracerebral serotonin concentration could lead to increased TRH concentration in brain tissues. The increase in TRH is an anorectic and rather depressant peptide. So if it is higher enough in certain parts of the cerebrum, it might be involved in the pathogenesis of depression in those patients who are predisposed, who are prone to that. And this mechanism is probably responsible for the blunted TSH response to TRH stimulation in depression. In animal studies, thyroid hormones influence noradrenergic and serotonergic neurotransmission, which is a target for current antidepressant therapies and plays a key role in the pathogenesis of depression. There are several interactions between serotonin and thyroid hormones are directly related as to the amount of serotonin in the platelets. Low thyroid hormone levels, and this particularly T3, diminishes cerebral bioenergetic metabolism, which has also been correlated with major depressive disorders. Thyroid hormones may activate the serotonin receptors, and synthesis of serotonin, which is used as a messenger to release TSH from the pituitary. And also to know that serotonin is involved with modulating intracellular T3 production via type 2 5-deiodinase. Well, the deiodinase, which is responsible for the conversion of T4 to T3 in the brain. So you see that serotonin plays an important role in disrupting thyroid when it is increasing. And therefore, SSRI, which inhibit the uptake of serotonin, may induce thyroid dysfunction. Another system which is very important is the dopamine levels, the dopamine and thyroid interaction. And you know that dopamine levels in the cerebral spinal fluid stimulate the paraventricular nucleus, stimulate the hypothalamus. And the paraventricular nucleus stimulates the whole axis via increased release of TRH. And this axis modulates TSH and further the T3 production. Well, making this short panoramic review on the interconnections of psychoactive drugs and thyroid function, we can conclude that disruption is common in patients treated with psychotropic compounds. Thyroid function testing should be performed in all patients under treatment with psychotropic drugs, particularly those under treatment with lithium, phenothiazines, and anti-epileptics. And thank you very much. Sometimes the sea is not very calm, and we have to navigate danger waters. Thank you.